Hello friends, listen to this treatise on demystification of dark matter and dark energy brought out by G. Prakash. Will you believe that we are surrounded by 20 times more unknown matter and energy? That is the dark matter and the dark energy. If it is recycled into normal matter and energy, we can see 20 times bigger universe. It is an established fact today. Among innumerable puzzles of science, the biggest puzzle on this day is the mystery of dark matter and dark energy in the cosmos, which according to me is now solved. If the facts stated herein, this treatise, are accepted by the world. It may be pointed out here that in astronomy and cosmology, the dark matter is a type of matter postulated to stand for a large part of the total mass in the universe. No telescope is able to show the dark matter. While the dark matter is unknown matter, the dark energy too is unknown energy, as already observed by Planck mission team, and as based on the standard model of cosmology, the total mass energy of the universe comprises 4.9% normal matter, 26.8% dark matter, and 63.3% dark energy. Of this ratio, only 5% of matter and energy is known to us, while 95% of the same is still unknown or undetected so far by any scientific approach. The undetected matter and energy, which constitutes 95% of the entire universe, is altogether called the dark matter and the dark energy. Neither does it absorb light, nor does it reflect light. However, it can only be judged by its gravitational effect on galaxies. It does not react with our ordinarily known matter. This is the reason for lack of information as well as understanding about dark matter and dark energy. This is the reason for lack of information as well as understanding about dark matter and dark energy. As a result, such a laxity of information about dark matter and dark energy has made particle physics incomplete. Not only this, the standard model of cosmos is also incomplete due to this laxity. Therefore, to solve the dark matter mystery is to know the entirety and comprehensiveness of science. It may cause concern to one and all as to why I am taking initiative to solve the mystery of dark matter and dark energy. Let me tell you that this subject has been concerning me over past 20 years, and my earlier book entitled Awaiting Annihilation of the Universe has already referred to the dark matter, which is useful in the cycling of gravitational energy of black hole into simple ordinary matter. I have drawn inspiration from the same book to solve this mystery. Let us here try to understand what the dark matter and the dark energy are. We just know 1% of them. The earlier made contribution of the space scientists, namely John Woot, 1932, Fritz Zwicky, 1933, and Lady Vera Rubin, 1965, in this regard, cannot be ignored. According to PMT, that is Planck mission team, the dark matter and the dark energy constitute 95% of the universe, while the remaining 5% is ordinary matter and energy, which is known to us. The aforesaid 95% also includes 25% dark matter and 65% dark energy. It may be known that the quantity of dark matter and ordinary matter is continuously decreasing, while the quantity of dark energy is continuously increasing. As a result, the universe is expanding, in other words, accelerating due to the dark matter and dark energy. It may also be known that the entire 95% of the dark matter and dark energy is slightest in amount to act or react against ordinary matter and energy. It is for this reason the dark matter is also called weakly interacting massive particles, in short, WIMP. Similarly, the dark energy is called quintessence energy. 8 years of observation and analysis since 1932 show that the dark matter produces some kind of binding or attractive force. This force keeps the stars, their galaxy, and their cluster of galaxies bound together. Its presence can be observed in the center of galaxy or galaxies. The characteristic of dark energy is that it produces some kind of repulsive force which keeps the stars, their galaxy, or their cluster of galaxies apart or separated from each other. This energy is responsible for expansion of the universe. However, the proportional presence of the dark matter and dark energy decides whether the stars, their galaxy, or cluster of galaxies should remain bound together or apart. While the existence of dark matter is generally accepted by the mainstream scientific community, there is no direct evidence of the same. But indirectly, its existence cannot be denied. What we are ignorant of about the dark matter and the dark energy is as follows. Number 1. What exactly is the dark matter? Number 2. What exactly is the dark energy? Number 3. What are the dark matter and the dark energy made up of? Number 4. Why, where, when, and how are the dark matter and the dark energy generated? Number 5. Whether the new understanding about the dark matter and the dark energy is helpful in redefining the standard model of cosmos. A question is raised here. What exactly is the dark matter? And the answer is, it is 99% of fused form of atom having 1% of its relics remained unchanged. It is 1% baryonic and 99% non-baryonic active structure prone to absorb energy to reduce 1% baryonic relics. The major role of each dark matter particle is to achieve 100% non-baryonic stage and to reduce its own last remains of baryonic matter. The dark matter is intelligent matter which possesses information of matter making. At the initial and final stages, the dark matter is in micro shape, size, and mass, but at middle stage it gains mega size by accumulating more and more non-baryonic matter. Another question is, what exactly is the dark energy? And the answer is, the dark energy is second, third, and final stages of the same dark matter. It does behave like energy due to change of its reduced form. The reduced content of baryonic matter from 1% to 00001% make the dark matter behave like the dark energy. It may be called dilution of dark matter. It is less prone to absorb energy. Absorb even lowest frequency of energy and so it gets shifted to the outskirt of atom, matter, star, galaxy, or cluster of galaxies. The change in the mode of absorption of energy and lack of baryonic content make the energy a repulsive force. This repulsive force is produced by non-baryonic element of dark energy. What is the dark matter and the dark energy made up of? And the answer is, the dark matter is composed of 99% non-baryonic matter and 1% baryonic matter, whereas the dark energy is composed of 99.99% non-baryonic and 0.00001% baryonic matter. The next question is, why, where, when, and how are the dark matter and the dark energy generated? The answer is, originally the dark matter is generated from the atom or molecule of matter. The dark energy is derived from the dark matter. It is the second, third, and final stages of dark matter, which had very much reduced its own baryonic content. It may be further explained as under. An atom or a molecule starts forming the dark matter when it does not need to produce any gravitational field or force or energy. Under such a condition, the atom starts to fuse in itself. By absorbing energy, it starts to reduce internal atomic momentum, starts to produce non-baryonic matter. The process of transformation is so slow that the time starts moving backward and not forward. A backward time zone starts moving when the atom starts turning into dark matter. The long-living, medium-sized, stable star, like the Sun, produces dark matter in its inner space or core. Such a star and its exterior thermal emission produces sufficient gravitational field for its internal and external momentum in the whole mass. As a result, the inner place or core of the star's mass starts fusing, absorbing energy, and turning into non-baryonic form. At initial stage, the dark matter is hardest and compact one. But in later stages, the dark matter gets liberated from the clutches of the star and moves towards strongest source of gravitational field like black hole. The major quantity of dark matter, just double of that produced during the event of Big Crunch, must have taken place before the early universe was formed. The Big Crunch of the universe will take place when baryonic mass and energy is reduced to 1% and the dark energy is increased to 99%. Then the dark energy will get recycled into dark matter along with the baryonic matter. As a result, 50-50% of baryonic matter and non-baryonic matter will come into existence just before the Big Crunch event takes place. It may be said that major quantity of dark matter must have certainly got generated during the process of Big Crunch of the universe, and it is a repeated phenomenon. What was or what would be the fate of universe in relation to dark matter and dark energy? And the answer is, during the formation of earlier universe, about 13.7 billion years ago, there was no dark energy. There was only dark matter as 63% and ordinary matter as 37% of the universe. After 13.7 billion years, today, the ordinary matter is reduced to 5%, while the dark matter is reduced to 25%, and the dark energy is increased from 0 to 70%. The future universe will possess 1% ordinary matter and 99% dark energy. It is because the dark matter will get transformed into dark energy. The thirst for energy will be increased multifold by the dark energy, and then all galaxies of the universe will move along their dark energy towards the brightest spot of the universe. This will be the starting point of Big Crunch of the universe. During the process of Big Crunch, the nuclei of each atom in all galaxies will get split, replace their dark matter content, generate new baryonic particle, and get assembled with it. During such happening, the dark energy will get recycled into baryonic energy and then into atom or the matter. It might be noted that after as well as before the Big Crunch, when newly generated matter did not face any resistance from its outer space, the matter again started to generate the dark matter in the internal core of atom, that is nuclei. As a result, 63% dark matter was produced during formation of earlier universe. Major role of dark matter and dark energy. Other than Big Crunch and Big Bounce of the universe, both the dark matter and the dark energy are sole conservator of baryonic and non-baryonic mass and energy of the universe. Both of them keep up the unit value of the universe with no gain and no loss. They maintain the first law of thermodynamics in balance. Both of them preserve the baryonic matter and energy to spread beyond limit of space by binding with them and bring them back during the Big Crunch and Big Bounce of the universe. Thus, the dark matter stabilizes the atom and saves it from further disintegration. One question crops up is the dark matter a part of atom? Does it play any role in radioactivity of matter? And the answer is, the dark matter is a part of atom. It is less than 1% of atomic structure. The dark matter present in the atom plays the binding and dispersing role within itself and in relation to its environment. The dark matter is a composition of 99% non-baryonic matter and 1% baryonic matter. When the baryonic matter content of dark matter increases in the dark matter, its binding force also increases. But when the non-baryonic content of the dark matter increases and the baryonic content decreases, the repulsive force generates from the dark matter. It imbalances the atom, loosens its binding force as well as its radioactivity. The stability and balance of the atom is decided by the presence of quantity of dark matter and dark energy in the core as well as on the surface of atom. The dark matter is not only present in the nuclei of atom, but its presence is also found on the surface of atom to the extent of 2-fold to 8-fold maximum. Yes. Now another question is, what kind of dark matter is used to produce the normal matter in black hole? And the answer is, the black hole receives the dark matter from two different sources. One is produced in the star's dark matter, having 99% non-baryonic and 1% baryonic content, while the other is produced in the process of crushing of the stars and stardust in the black hole. The dark matter particles, which contain more than 1% baryonic content, absorb energy and increase baryonic content only, and also get liberated from the clutches of black hole, giving vent to production of normal matter. The dark matter which is produced from the stars, having less than 1% baryonic matter, absorbs energy from black hole and increases its non-baryonic content and also gets liberated from the clutches of black hole. Thank you.